scrimmage with three tight ends in, and Michigan State says, we have to see if this backup quarterback can do anything pro football. We're not going to let you just line up in front of it and try to protect it.
This Iowa team did face Scott Higgins, who he said in 2017, he was at Miami. 7-13, first pass for Hill, on a completion right back to Vines, who nearly escaped on the spin move, but was dumped down to 28. So got it back into a manageable situation on third down. Kind of long yardage for this Iowa offense, but a very productive play. And then Ryan Ferris is off on second down, beat behind the sticks. Again, staying on schedule is important for all teams, but paramount for an offense like Iowa.
That was something that Michigan State defensive coordinator Scott Hagen to mention as his number one key, get them off schedule. That's when you can affect the quarterback and do what you want. Go down to seven. Hill. Let's it fly. Incomplete. His receiver, Eric Ball, slips. And it will be fourth down.
A pretty good anticipation by Deacon Hill, and you can see the arm strength. Eric Ball just slips, getting out of his break right there. Doesn't have a chance to make a play on the ball. And the corner, Dylan Tatum, if he'd have been looking, he might have had an interception.
State coach staff said Tatum's third pass quarterback, and now Deacon Hill trapped all around the clock. Redshirted in 2021 this time. Didn't see much play time. Of course, Taylor was second up of the day. So deep in the fair by Henry Dane at the 25 for a 47-yard boot. Redshirt the first year, didn't play a ton last year, as mentioned. He's trying to learn on the fly as he transferred in this past spring. Let's go downstairs to Catherine Tappan.
Well, no, it's just some more on the cutting way. Jay Higgins told me we lose sight of what's really important. So many more serious problems going on, and we're truly blessed to play football. That's what he notices when this wave happens. And opposing teams, as Todd mentioned, they know about this tradition, know of him, told us it puts everything in perspective to be able to put a smile on their faces when we wave while we're playing the game of football. It's rewarding.
We talked to some of the players from the Iowa side. They literally said, correct, what we need to do for the kids, and we believe it.
Yeah, they Iowa's got to figure something else out. Now, they're not giving up the big pass, but every completion so far by Noah Kim, who is 6-for-6, has been the lead card. And Iowa knew it and knew that he was a problem. And see, the problem is they play mostly zone. They don't play man coverage. And right now, Carter did a nice job finding some openings in the zone.
He already has a career high in receptions with six of them, but the two here, and you talk to the zone coaches, they knew this on Iowa's side that this was going to happen because it did last week with Drew Aller. And Michigan State knew that they had to do this. Take the defense games, and I know Kent right now is giving every single underneath route a major chance on his first look.
Jay Johnson said it's important to be good, but most important to be patient in our pass game.
They target the first down on that second down scamper, which I reported.
Long screw.
Jay McNamara went to the tent. Malik Carr, the star on the other side, was at the free throw line. Goes to the tent for Michigan State.
Some other guys have to step up. Number 15, Jerron Glover has been kind of a go-to guy here early in the season.
More than
one catch more last year. Jackson, number 10, the transfer from Virginia, he's there.